I have a confession to make. I didn't want this to be a surface level video talking about tips and tricks that others have shared, so I went deep into research. I didn't need to search a ton of keywords on ChatGPT to find a pattern. I just needed 10 searches. Plus, digging deep into the output provided and confronting ChatGPT on why it did what it did. So since businesses care about having their brand mentioned on AI search platforms like ChatGPT, I asked these action keywords to have ChatGPT list products instead of asking informational queries. And what I found is astonishing, and we're gonna talk about that in this video. Let's go. Now, first things first. The foundation of appearing on ChatGPT is if your site is indexed on Bing, and we have discussed that in this video right here. But in this video, we are deep diving into ChatGPT's answers to get insights. For example, this: best website builders for small business owners. I would note down all the platforms that ChatGPT has provided, and then I would go to the bottom of the answer and click on the sources button and note all these sources that ChatGPT has cited from. And then I would do a domain rating check using the free tool provided by Ahrefs. I would visit those cited pages to note the date of publication or the update, and I will also take note of all the products that were mentioned on the page. Additionally, I would search for the same keyword on Bing and Google and browse through the first 10 pages of each search engine to find the ranking position of all the pages that were cited. And finally, I've put all the information into this handy spreadsheet. So I said I've only searched for 10 keywords, but you can somewhat guess how long it took me to compile all this information. It is more than 24 hours, and I would really appreciate if you can support us with a thumbs up. And well, you could say I can use Perplexity's Comet browser to search for the ranking positions, but after analyzing its output compared with my manual browsing, some of the pages that Comet found on Google or Bing, I couldn't find them. And some that Comet couldn't find, I found that in the search results. So the only way for me to conduct this research was purely manual. And stick with me to the end, because the final example is the one that lets you understand everything we talk about in this video. So let's go. My initial thought was that ChatGPT would list products that were mentioned most from all its cited sources. For example, out of all the cited sources, 8 out of 10 mentioned product A. So I would assume that product A would definitely be included in the answer. But that's not the case. Check this out. My search query was best expense tracker apps, and it has provided me with all these expense tracker apps. I went through all the cited sources and added each of the mentioned apps right here at this column. And then I did a count on each app that were mentioned by different pages. And guess what? Some of the apps that were mentioned more than others were not part of the ChatGPT's answer. For example, this SAP Concur. It was not mentioned in the answer. And I find it quite weird, so I confronted ChatGPT. Pardon my grammar and English, I just wanted an answer. So I asked, why did you list Wallet Hub and Lunch Money when they are only mentioned once? The frequency count for SAP Concur was 4, but why didn't you include it in your output? And then QuickBooks and Zoho Expense were mentioned the same number of times as Rocket Money and Monarch Money. Why aren't they listed? And it has provided me with some insights, particularly this part of the answer. It says expense tracking app fall into different buckets: personal finance and budgeting, and business or professional. They try to provide a mix, but they also look into the intent of the query. People who search for keywords like best apps often imply personal or small business use. And that's why SAP Concur, Zoho Expense, and QuickBooks are not part of the ChatGPT answer. As for Expensify, if you search for the company on Google and visit its pricing page, you will see that it is suitable for individuals and small businesses because it is not as expensive as QuickBooks and the others, which makes it a better option for the query. So what does this tell us? It means if we are selling products or services, we need to be hyper-focused on the groups of people we are selling to and make it known on our product pages, because ChatGPT does reference manufacturer or product listings. For example, the query was best cordless lawnmowers for small yards. And the thing is, this brand wasn't even mentioned in any of the cited sources, yet it appeared on ChatGPT's answer. And as I confront ChatGPT, it replied with the product shows up strongly in manufacturer pages, retailer listings, and independent reviews as a compact, low-area cordless mower, which matches the small yard description. So if your target market is people looking for cordless mowers for a small area, you've got to specify it in your product pages. If your app is meant for big corporations and not for individuals, you've got to mention it in your description of the app. And if your product serves different use cases, such as for RankMath, we serve agencies, small businesses, local businesses, and others, we need to be creating pages like best WordPress SEO plugin for small businesses, free WordPress plugin for local businesses, WordPress SEO plugin for businesses with multiple locations, etc. But your question would be, wouldn't that be duplicate or thin content since all the plugin recommendations are similar on all pages? We were taught in SEO that we should write one comprehensive article that includes all the different intent variations. And that is absolutely correct in the eyes of traditional search engines. But ChatGPT does not view content like traditional search engines. It only cites from pages that literally match the search intent. So here's what I recommend you do. Create separate pages targeting distinct hyper-focused keywords. For example, we have a high-level article that covers the generic best WordPress SEO plugins in 2025. And we create another article that targets a different angle, best WordPress SEO plugins for small businesses. The content will change its tone to match the small business's need. You don't need drastic changes, just the information that are relevant to small businesses. Then we have another article that targets bloggers. So all the contents are somewhat similar but adjusted to the different intent. And we have to first follow the best practices for traditional search engines and at the same time allow ChatGPT to access your other pages. And to do it, we would add canonical tags, which means you're telling traditional search engines that there are many different pages with similar content, but focus on this one main page and index only this. Ignore the rest. So essentially, you want to add a canonical tag to these duplicated or similar pages, pointing to the main page so that traditional search engines will index only this page. Now, if you are using other SEO plugins, you will have to find a way to do that. But for RankMath, you want to copy the URL of the main page, go to the duplicated or similar pages, visit the RankMath tab, and on the Advanced tab, you want to keep the page indexed. And in the canonical URL field, you want to paste the URL of the main page here. Do the same for the other duplicate page as well. This will serve both the traditional search engines as well as ChatGPT and other AI platforms. So when you are ultra specific in who your target audiences are, you have created pages and optimized the title, headings, and meta description to match the literal query intent, there is a higher chance that your product, service, or brand being mentioned. If you want your brand to be mentioned on ChatGPT, don't block any of its crawlers. You see, OpenAI uses three different crawlers. OAI SearchBot and ChatGPT User are meant to help ChatGPT get answers from the web. And GPTBot is meant for crawling the web to train its AI model. Now, you would think that you can allow the first two bots to crawl your site to get information for their answers, and you can block GPTBot because you don't want your content to be used to train ChatGPT. But after doing the research, I would say it is in the best interest of companies not to block that crawler because ChatGPT references their trained knowledge a lot. For example, the query was best website builders for small business owners, and one of the sources were Tech Advisor. But the problem was, I went to search for the same keyword in Google and Bing, and the page was nowhere to be found. So if the source wasn't found on search engines, where did it come from? It explained that its trained data is up to 2024, and it contains many older but relevant review pages. Sometimes when ChatGPT builds a balanced summary, it supplements live search results with reputable older sources already in its knowledge. So if you are a brand, it makes total sense for your content to be used to train ChatGPT. So if you have something like this in your robots.txt file, you want to make sure to remove it. If you are a RankMath user, you can find your robots.txt file in RankMath's general settings and click on the edit robots.txt. From here, you can use the editor to edit the file.
So it will be a stronger signal if your brand is in ChatGPT's training data as well as in its live search data. So do not block that GPT bot. But we truly understand that if your site focuses on informational content, you may not be inclined to have your content train the AI model. So if you want to block the GPT bot and other AI model crawlers, you can check out point 6 of this video right here. I will walk you through step by step on how to block them using robots.txt.
Do you know ChatGPT has two groups of cited sources? And if your brand is mentioned in the main group,
there is a higher chance that your brand will be part of the answer, among other factors like the intent and referencing trained data. If you do any research on ChatGPT, scroll to the bottom of the answer, click on the sources button, and you will see the first set of citations. When you scroll down, you will see the second set of citations under the More section. I didn't pay much attention to the two sets of citations until I analyzed the results. You see, I have highlighted those that are mentioned by ChatGPT, and then for those that are in the main set of cited sources, I would add a main set beside them. And 100% of the time, if it is cited by the main set, which is the first part of the cited sources, they will be part of the ChatGPT answer. There is not one that comes without the main set. And when I confronted ChatGPT about the two different sets of citations, it affirmed that the products or steps in the main citations are the ones it considered authoritative and trustworthy enough to shape the answer. But of course, it doesn't mean that if the product is mentioned in the main set of citations, it is 100% that the product will be part of the answer. You see, many others were not mentioned. And that's because of other factors like the intent and trained data, as we have mentioned. But the gateway for your brand to be part of the answer is to be part of the main cited sources. So here's what I recommend you do. Create a marketing avatar, which is a visual representation of the group of people you are targeting. And think from their perspective, what kind of action keywords will they be typing into ChatGPT? Such as if you are a pet toy seller and your target avatar is a dog owner who care about safety and durability, they may search for which chew resistant dog toys are made with non-toxic materials, say for aggressive chewers, and under $25. Or what are the best interactive dog toys that relieve boredom, contain no harmful chemicals, and are priced under $30. Or do any squeaky dog toys exist that are tear resistant, made with safe fabrics, and affordable under $18. And once you have a list of queries, you want to type them in ChatGPT, then go to the bottom of the answer and check out its sources and visit those pages in the main set of citations to see if they have mentioned your product, service, or brand. If not, you want to reach out to them and maybe work something out. Take note that the citation sources are not consistent. If you search the same keyword a couple of times, the citation source links might be different. So I will recommend that you do the same search a couple of times and reach out to all the pages found in the main set of citations. So through our research, we found that most of the pages in the main set of citations are from high authority sites. You see, on this query, all the main cited sites are of high domain authority, but they are not exactly found on page 1 of Bing or Google searches. We found cited pages on page 3, page 5, page 7, and even on page 10. So this means one thing. Your site authority matters more than rankings. And the best way I know to grow authority and influence, it is not by asking for backlinks. It is by creating unique information, such as a research paper featuring your proprietary data. If you say that your product or brand is the best, prove it by creating case studies. Expand beyond written content. Have a podcast, YouTube channel, Instagram reels, and basically appear everywhere your customers are, and your brand will naturally grow influence and authority. Now, one other interesting thing I want to show you. You see, as I did the research on the best expense tracker, I found that Wallet Hub is only mentioned once. It is the same with others. So I asked ChatGPT how it determines if it should be in the list, and it told me that the context of the mention matters. The one source that mentioned Wallet Hub didn't just list it. It positioned Wallet Hub as both a review platform and as offering its own app that functions as an expense tracker. So for example, we as RankMath, a WordPress SEO plugin, should not only rely on third parties to mention our brand, but we should also write a listicle that targets keywords like best WordPress SEO plugins that reviews the list of products objectively and offer our own product in the list. That could add more weight if it is cited as a source. So believe it or not, this is exactly what ChatGPT told me to do. I'll leave it to you to decide if it makes sense. After reviewing the data, we noticed that 86% of the main cited sources are content written or updated in the same year. The remaining 14% comes from ChatGPT's trained knowledge. An article from Ahrefs confirmed this finding as well. So instead of creating content one after another, put some focus into updating your content at least once a year to keep the information relevant. Many websites and blogs are gradually fading out. But if you are here to stay, this is the strategy that will propel your brand to be mentioned on ChatGPT. So with all the research and information that I've collected, it gave me the thought that if I want to truly know the process of how ChatGPT finds its sources and aggregates them into answers, I need to ask a query that ChatGPT has not been trained on much yet. So I asked this query, best AI tools that can generate 3D environment. This is something that I heard of this year, and ChatGPT was trained up to 2024 at the time of this recording. And it has provided us with these AI tools. When we look at the sources, I did the same search on Google and Bing, and I just couldn't find these ARXIV pages that were referenced a couple of times. So I asked, why are the pages from the site not rank on either Bing or Google, and yet they are cited as a reference? So the highlight was ChatGPT will expand its research sources, especially for fast-moving areas, where new tools often first appear in research papers, months before mainstream blogs catch up. And here's the important part. It asks if I want to know how ChatGPT built the list of product recommendations. It says that's the layer behind why some sources make it, even if they are invisible in normal search. And of course, I said, yes, please. So the first thing it will do is to get information from traditional search engines. The information collected is good for knowing what's out there, but the problem includes recycled information, rely on marketing claims, and it may not be up to date. So if the information from traditional search engines is not good enough, it will look at research sources, such as academic papers or journals. And this is how ChatGPT formulates its answers. When it searches the web, it will look for relevance. So if your content is not exactly relevant to the query, it will not be considered, as we have said earlier in this video. And this is the key, even if it is not SEO ranked. And then the second filter is to personalize the answer. If the query includes best tools, top 10 apps for, best products for, it would signal a personal preference. So products that serve an individual will be prioritized over corporate solutions. And if the query is more technical, it will find research papers. And finally, it will cross-check the gathered information with either the research papers, manufacturer listings, distributor listings, trusted review sites, and others to formulate the best list of solutions. Now, there is one more variable that isn't included, which is the trained data. During the first filter, it checks the search results against its trained knowledge. So this is the exact process ChatGPT goes through. And that's why it is important that you align your business with it so that your brand will be mentioned in the answers.
So you can't understand ChatGPT without really digging into and analyzing its output. And I hope that this video has shed some light on this topic. If this video helped, do help us out by smashing that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your brand traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.